Hello viewers, and welcome back to our Let's Play of Stronghold Crusader 2. I'm your host, PPGChu, as always, and well, moving forwards with our Let's Play for the game. I finally had some time this weekend to play some more of this, so let's begin with mission number 3, Antioch, inside the Lionheart learning campaign here.
You catch up with Richard outside Antioch, where the siege is at a stalemate. You must build your forces and capture the city quickly, as Saladin's counterattacks are becoming more violent by the day.
Alright, so I guess we're just supposed to... Yeah, this will be actually one of the first major, say, battles inside the game. Where, yeah, you have the... You'll see it in a sec.
I suggest we hurry, as more and more of Saladin's troops are arriving in the plains beyond.
Right, so it'll be this mishmash between us having like our troops over here, and the enemy having their our fortress over here rather, and the enemy having their fortress over here, and yeah, it's this semi duel between like two forces building up their guys, at the same time building up their economies and their fighting forces at one time, and it's pretty neat.
Great news, sire.
Combination.
We now have rangers at our disposal.
Right, so it looks like we start off with a whole ton of resources. So with that said, I'm going to build a few structures just right off the bat. And what
Your company of rangers is skilled with both sword and bow, making them excellent support troops and scouts.
As I was saying, what I want to do here is that I just really want to build up our forces as fast as possible. So with that said, I'm just going to try to roll out here with a ton of stuff. I'll put down 2 archery hovels inside the first game. These things would build forces really, really slowly, but inside the second one, or inside this one, they seem to build much faster. And with that said, I think we'll just build like 3 stalls here, 2 for... 2 for archers and 1 for maces right now. We'll just get that to work. Engineers, and in the meantime, actually, we should probably build up a few food structures as well. So what I think I'll do here is I'll build 1 more of these apple, or actually no, build 2 more of these apple orchards. We have one place already producing dairy and like farm stuff, so that's not bad. Let's actually get a wheat farm going. And with that, we're actually one of the more efficient ways to actually build food inside this game is to just do a wheat farm and the mill and the bakery, but that mill is oddly expensive, so I don't really want to buy it just yet. So in that case, I think what I'll do here is that I'll get a pig farm right by the granary going, and that'll give our guys some variety inside their foods, so hopefully that'll make it so that the happiness is higher, and at that point I should, or I hope to be able to bump that tax rate higher as well. So we'll see what we can do there. Inside this area, what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to trade some of our stone, which we don't necessarily need for this map, for some gold, because what I want to do going from there is that I want to build a blacksmith's, probably. Checking out our guys here, looks like we'll be able to build a few macemen soon.
Our engineers have had an idea that is most popular with our troops, if not with the more sentimental farmers. We should load the trebuchets with diseased livestock and rain pestilence down upon the enemy castle prior to a direct assault.
And just checking over here, I wanted to see whether or not we should buy some macemen or some of the other guys here. We should probably get a few more pikemen out there, so I think I'll build a weaponsmith as well. The thing with it is that right now I don't really want to build any swords, simply because you can only turn them into these rangers for this battle. And they're not the greatest is the thing. So that's that. And let's see how we're doing over here. So these guys should be working, they should be producing a lot of iron. And the thing about the iron is that I'm honestly probably just going to sell a whole bunch of it, because I've tried this mission once before, and from what I saw, we really do need to manage the amount of cash we generate here really, really tightly. And with that said, I mean, resource selling is probably the best way to go with that. So let's see, once again, we'll sell off some lumber here. Yeah, the key to it is just really having a good economy to get things going. And I think we'll go with one more mace workshop thing. And then afterwards, I think we'll go for one armorer's workshop soon enough.
Might it be a good idea to ramp up the production of weapons in our workshops, my liege?
Yeah.
In his impatience to attack, good King Richard has sadly neglected this aspect.
And that is exactly what I'm doing right now. Really need to build a few more weapons for our guys. So we are doing, yeah, just that, really. So, let's see. Yeah, why don't you look at that? Another huge stack of wood coming into this area. And how many bows do we have? How many armory things do we have? We actually have a good amount of them. So I'm guessing we're only limited by the amount of people we're currently producing. In that case, I think it's time for a second hovel, because I like to have a large supply of guys just sitting about so I can easily convert them into fighting men. The thing about this game is that the production of people is just really, really fast compared to the other game, rather compared to the first one. Inside the first one, oh man, it would take ages to build these things.
Attack, my lord.
Yeah, and they're gonna attack us, but that's fine. I'm gonna get a second ox tither out here because we have two of these iron mines, and it looks like one actually stopped working because it was just fully stockpiled up. So there we go. And iron will be sold afterwards, but for now, I guess we're supposed to go on the defense.
Right. Rangers,
so let's get all of these guys set up. Yeah, the rangers over there are all-rounder type of troops, so they're not good for everything, but I mean, they're not bad in anything either. The thing about them, though, is that they just seem kind of weird in the sense that they don't have armor, despite being like the semi-melee unit, so they're kind of fragile in that sense. And there we go, their archers are going down pretty fast.
What's afoot, sir?
So that's good. And there. So let's see, what should we do now? We have a nice selection of bows, we have a nice selection of maces being produced, and some of those halberds or, you know, pole arm weapons. So I guess now it'll be time to get one of these armor stalls open, and we'll just let that run. Here, let's actually get rid of some of this iron, because we don't need a ton of it. And there, that should give us enough cash to actually buy another siege thing, or alternatively just an absolute ton of guys. So I think I'll buy like this little pool of macemen and things like that. Nice thing about the macemen is that they can just do that charging ability, which makes them so helpful. Right, so there, now we have a nice little blob of guys. So that's pretty good.
Action stations. This building is currently functioning, my lord.
And would you look at that? More wood to sell off, more other stuff. So get rid of that, and I think we'll just convert it into more archers.
Have enough gold to train this unit.
Just
and
give
there.
Us the target. We're ready.
And would you look at that? Our army is slowly building up. So now that we have some troops, I guess we can try to make a small play for some of the other stuff right now. So let's grab all of these guys, and what I'm going to do with them is that I want them to take this area right here, and then later on I want them to push through all of this so then we can actually get to the main fortifications of these guys right here. The thing about them is that all we have to do is just break in here and kill their lord. So with that said, we only have to really just breach like perhaps one place inside their line here, and I'm thinking it's this area. The thing is that we need some pretty slow moving but heavily armored guys to go through there nice and properly. So there, yep, the macemen will do a great job in pushing through there. Archers will hopefully do their thing to the guys on the walls.
Our strings are waxed.
And I think we just collected a whole bunch of other weapons, so that's good. Yeah, now we have a few crossbows, so we can get a few of those out in a second.
At your service.
So I'll see what we can do there. For now, I think what I'll do is that I'll get our guys to try to tunnel through the wall over here.
Just give us the target.
Let's try to do that. Let's get the mace. We're not the mace, but the crossbowman out. Because we'll need these guys to deal with heavily armored targets. And it doesn't look like we can produce them, so that should be pretty helpful.
Our boars shall sing.
And man, that is going to be quite difficult to break through, but afterwards we should be able to get the siege equipment through. So that'll be good. And how are we doing for iron production? Looks like things are being loaded up. So that is very, very good. And that should give us some more stuff to sell soon enough. Let's just get rid of a whole bunch of that, of those units of lumber like that.
Peasants needed, sire.
And there we go. We can produce a ton of pikemen now as well.
We're on the move. Bowman, make ready. Lordship.
So would you look at that? We can really amp up production now.
Let's get going. Bikes are ready.
And we might as well smash up these buildings over here. So let's just do that.
Your grace.
And afterwards, I think I'll just move the catapult over here, and hopefully we'll be able to take down, like, this big tower. And then back here, they also have a ballista. So we'll try to get rid of those two things right there before moving forwards. And how's our iron? Our iron is holding, so let's sell that off once again. Sell off the wood, too. And we could probably just make, honestly, a stone mine just for the sake of building up goods for us to sell. The main thing is, though, is really just generating cash. Well. Apparently we're under attack somewhere. So let's see, what is happening? Oh, there's nothing really going on over there. But in the event that we are actually under attack, I think I'll just bull up our army and keep them right there. And, oh. Let's see. So now, with our siege equipment set up and all, I'm going to see whether or not we can move it close enough to range down that thing. Ah, so they're going to attack from over here. Right, so we'll get our guys to try to intercept these guys. See what we can do to take them down. And it's really nice that the the macemen can just run around all those guys just like that. They have some really heavily armored swordsmen over here, and this is why we need the crossbowmen. Because those things can go through armor, and they really add a lot to how much damage we're putting down. So we'll let them do that. In the meantime, I'll get our guys to defend the back ranks over here. And, ooh, in the meantime, our gold production is going pretty well, so that's not bad either. How's our food doing, though? Our food seems to be good. So, let's give our guys some more variety, seeing as that we have the ability to. So we'll put down another pig farm, another other farm thing. So that'll let a few people do that. And our supply of weapons is just going through the roof here. I think I'll get just 15 guys converted into archers in just one big group like that. And, oh, they're going for round two over here, apparently. And man, those archers die really, really fast, but those armored dudes do not go down easily. And how's the siege works going? I apparently hit the two buildings behind it, but not the actual tower itself. Bam, there we go. That was a nice hit.
My lord, marching boots, lads.
So let them just constantly do that. And back over here, let's actually grab some more siege equipment. Catapults only cost 100 points, but they're slightly worse at shooting. So we'll just they're slightly worse at range. So we'll see what we can do about that. Right now, let's sell off some more wood once again. Convert that into a few macemen for now. And we'll ball up these guys. Man, they're launching another wave. Well, at least we're handling those guys with a startling amount of efficiency, so that's good. I guess we'll sell off a few of these pikes for now. We can sell off the swords, in all honesty, because I'm probably not going to build any more rangers. And let's see. Let's get just 12 macemen out there. There we go.
Mace's ready.
That's gonna blow them up. Let's get them stockpiled over here. And how are we doing on the siege front? That tower is going down, but it's going down very, very slowly. Soon enough, we'll have the catapult over here too, doing its thing. Ooh, direct hit on those guys. And they have a priest down there, the guy in the middle. That guy apparently heals people. Not really sure if it's around. Yeah, it looks like, yeah, it's around him. So he'll just gradually do his thing. And, oh, would you look at that third volley, guys.
Right. Your Highness, we'll take care of it. Just
let's get the archers battle right now to just pummel these guys for a bit of time.
Your Highness, what's going down? Smash them to bits.
And let's send the basement on the one remaining archer. There you go. He died instantly. Let's see what else we can do. Get a few more guys out just like that. And yeah, it looks like we have weapons production down in all honesty. We just need the money to fund them.
Pac-Man, forward!
So that'll be just that. Looks like the blight thing was over, so that's good. Wow, this forest bit is actually shrinking quite fastly too.
This building is currently functioning, my lord.
And I think that's pretty much it for what we have to do here. How is our army looking right now as well? So we have 23 archers, 11 of those guys, or 23 macemen, 14 of those pikemen, so it's not bad. It's not bad at all.
Departing, set us a task.
So I think we might try to launch an attack onto these guys soon enough, seeing as how it seems as though we have, it looks like we have enough stuff to really smash through there. You never know, though. We'll try. We'll see. So, one thing that I want to figure out is where can we actually get on? Where is there a place from which we can get on top of the fortifications from?
Calculating.
No, it doesn't look like there's anything connected to their main line here. So I think we'll just get our guys to just continue smashing this area.
Preparing.
Ooh. And I want to make a few holes into their lines, but not only that, I need to figure out a way to,
Nearly there, my liege. One final push and the city will be ours.
To get through there. Yeah, those catapults aren't going to last very long, especially when they have that ballista firing. So I guess we'll just get the trebuchet to continue doing its thing.
Weapons needed, sire?
Your mark, sire?
The people are excited about a forthcoming marriage, sire.
Ooh, that is good. Thank you, forthcoming marriage. That'll allow us to bump up the tax rate. And let's see, that's going to be $169 dollars per day, so that'll actually really help out our current situation. Wow, we actually have a lot of stuff there, a lot of logs and all. So with that said, you know what? Here's what I think I'll do. Since we have just so much logging going on, I'm going to build up like a little town area. And the main thing is that we can probably get those town folk to man some other jobs by now. So let's get one more armor smith thing working. Let's get a pike thing right next to it. And I'm going to get another thing to produce maces soon enough. So that'll staff a few people, and afterwards I think I'll focus on farming.
The enemy are attacking.
Right, so there. And, oh, they're attacking from, over here. Ooh, that is not good, actually. This thing needs to flee in that case. Luckily, it's only two of these things. And luck, no, that trebuchet is gonna go down. So that really sucks.
Bring 'em down.
But, I mean, at the same time, the gate is open to their fortress.
Your command. Look lively, pikes.
So let's see. Yeah, because that's not a good situation to be in. Let's see what we can do. I think what we'll do here is that we'll just get another catapult or two. I'm gonna get our guys balled up, and I think we'll just attack them right now, seeing as how I think we have enough troops to do it. It's just that all we need to do is just break through now. So with that said, I'm gonna sell off a ton of our food and a ton of our other stuff, now that we really were, I'd imagine that we don't need it anymore. And I'm just gonna get the rest of our guys equipped with stuff for now. And we'll see what we can do about making like a smash onto their
weapons needed, sire.
Onto the front gate now. So yeah, I'll get those things produced.
Peasants needed, sire.
My lord.
And oh, we'll get the tax rate balanced once again.
Forward.
And damn it. Oh my god.
At your disposal. Forward.
Get some peasants out. Where did those guys come from?
Recruits needed, sire.
Just gonna get a few more siege pieces out, but now that is, that kind of sucks. And we'll just get a mob of these catapults and things to just go over there and take down whatever they can, whatever they can find, really. There we go. Get like four or so catapults, and I just want to smash down like this bit of their defenses. We need to get rid of that ballista too.
Do not have enough gold to build this equipment.
So right, we're just gonna build all of this, get this stacked up right there, and we'll just get it going soon enough.
Let's get going. Catapult ready, my lord. Engineer detachment heading out.
And if we still have some weapons.
Weapons needed, sire.
Just gonna do that and grab a whole bunch of guys and send them here as well. So there.
How can we help?
Now it'll be just a measure of time waiting for the siege equipment to arrive, and then afterwards it should be pretty smooth going afterwards. Let's see what they actually have inside their town. They're just passively building things up, I guess.
Got some trouble. Ooh.
What is this? There are they're apparently building siege camps right in front of our place.
Your mark, sire. Daggers out, lads.
It's kind of weird, but all right.
Sire, we'll hold them off. My lord, they'll not get past us. What? Base is ready. Our bows shall sing.
Aye, sir.
Our tools are ready.
My lord.
Weapons needed, sire?
Your command. Forward! Right. Lordship.
Catapult ready, my lord.
Alright, so let's see, what do we have to break through here, now that the catapults are here. So that ballista will probably be one area of concern, but I think what we really just need to do is to just get rid of the towers right there, and afterwards I think things will be fine. So I'll try to do exactly just that. So let's get two of these catapults to, or actually no, let's just get them in here as a wave, really.
Your command.
Smash things up, and I think we'll just get our guys to act as cannon fodder for now to cover them. So let's see.
Base is ready.
The enemy are attacking.
We're ready.
Yeah, they're gonna fire those things. I was kind of worried for a second that the projectiles that they fire might be like AOE ones. That would have been really, really bad.
Woman, string up,
your highness.
Woman. Myth ready.
Let's get going. Best foot forward.
Right, so that's one tower down. Hopefully we can get the other one down very, very soon enough.
Ready, sir.
Loose arrows.
Right.
Ah, there we go. We got the ballista too. What I really want to do now is that I just want to clear up the way for our pikemen to just slowboat it over there, because they take a long ass time to walk from place to place. Guess we'll get the macemen in first to just cover things, really.
Need some heads crushing. We're ready.
What trouble's this?
There we go.
To the walls!
We are under attack.
Aye, sir. Captain, your command, sir.
And there. I think that's pretty much it for taking this area. And let's try to get everybody swarmed in this guy. There we go. And now their enemy lord is going down pretty fast, they know. Ooh, he's actually holding on. Hopefully with the archers coming in now, he'll go down a bit faster. And bah, the game has some pathing problems here. There's just so many people underneath the building for whatever reason. There we go. And there.
Victory!
So, solid battle right there. And I guess next time we'll just continue forwards to the
and sing sweetly.
The last mission inside the campaign here. So, I hope you guys liked episode, I believe, 3 here. Hope to see you guys back inside episode 4 shortly. Bye-bye till then.